evening, guys. Welcome to Anime Amigos. For our very first go of this, I'm Calvin Arrington. I'm the film reviewer for the Axia Film Society. This is my friend Reece.
Hello, everyone. I'm Reece Imalek. I tend to do smaller anime reviews and tokusatsu reviews on my Twitter.
That's a hell of an intro.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to do this one. We're going to do this every couple of months. We're going to be picking our favourites for each season. We're going to go over what our thoughts on the season were, what we felt was the best, what we thought was the worst. And generally, although we're going to be talking much more about what we liked than what we didn't like, because I don't think anyone we really bother that much when we don't like something.
No, we pretty much just ignore it.
I had a few of those in the fall season, because I was going on holiday, and I thought, I'm going to have to do a ton of catch-up when I get home. I am not going to bother to watch several episodes of a show I didn't really like all that much.
Yeah.
When I came. But we try to watch as much as possible, though.
Definitely.
But I think since we're new to this, I think anyone who's new, we're going to get in this, because we're going to have revolving... We're going to have one guy who's going to be regular with us starting next month. And after that, we're going to sort of be a regular shift about on who's who. And so I think we need to go... To give an idea of our taste, we'll go for our five favourite anime. So what would you say are your top five?
My top five? King of Braves, Gal Gaigar. Then Tengen Toppa, Gurren Lagann. Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Cowboy Bebop. And I always struggle for a fifth because it's always dead close. So I'd probably go and Kill the Kill.
I was about to say, I'm about to put the gun to your head.
Yeah.
I was about to say, I'm about to put the gun to your head. And that was the thing. But no, my five, and again, I always prefer to have a seven because seven's a good that was a number they give you on Desert Island Discs. But my five would be Eureka 7, Clan Ad After Story, Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood, Death Note and Cowboy Bebop.
Good choices.
Yeah, no, I am the most... I mean, only one of those is even remotely obscure. That's what's so bad about me. I try my best to be the obscure anime, but it does no work. So, since I think they're pretty clear on who we are,
yeah.
And hang on a sec. Yeah, it is still on. Did I turn on the microphone? Are we going to have to do this again?
Yeah, just end up doing the whole thing in sign language.
Oh, this is. See how professional we are on this show. So let's go over it. What were our thoughts? Shall we start with what our thoughts on the winter season as a whole were?
Sure.
So, winter 2017, this was coming off fall 2017. Fall 2017 sort of came about, and it was a really good season. Like, fall 2016 was one of the best seasons of anime I had. I just loved almost everything that came out.
Yeah, there's no dispute in that.
Even some of the shows that were just okay, even the shows that didn't make my sort of best of the year list, there was a lot of shows that could have been any other year would have. So like I didn't get hugely into Yuri on Ice, for example, but even then I thought it was a good anime.
Yeah.
Keijo was nothing to write home about, but I still really enjoyed it and watched it every week. And I've just realised I've lost the remote for the camera, so this is going to be a very smooth transition when we decide to stop this. Oh god! It's on my lap. See how professional we are on this vlog. So we're coming into this in the winter season. What did we think of the winter season overall?
I really enjoyed it.
You really enjoyed it?
Yeah. Which I know has got mixed reviews off people, but I thought it was a good season.
It was eventually. It didn't feel like that at the start.
Oh no.
At the start, this really felt like this was going to be the dumpster fire we all thought it was going to be. Like, there was nothing was really amazing in its first couple of episodes. Like, even something like, even things like Konosuba. Konosuba was what everyone was really kind of into the idea of it. They were into the idea that this was going to be something amazing. And even then, the first couple of episodes weren't that amazing.
Yeah.
Everything we were, was there anything? Was there anything you didn't see that was really big? Anything at all?
No, I think I pretty much saw a few episodes of near enough everything this season.
I haven't seen Blue Exorcist. I haven't seen anything of the second season of Blue Exorcist because I'm waiting. I watched the first season in the dub, and I'm waiting for the second. I'm waiting for the dub to come out on the second season.
Yeah, I saw the first couple of episodes of that, and it is good.
Is it genuinely good? Because I've had mixed feelings towards Blue Exorcist. I thought it was amazing by the end of it, but
yeah.
I didn't start out. I started out really liking it, then it kind of lost my interest in the middle, and then it picked my interest back up at the end, which is something I'm hoping is not going to happen.
Well, if you got picked up by the end, you're going to be a bit disappointed. But no spoilers here, people.
No. We're gonna avoid spoilers for the most part. We might not be able to do that next month, but we'll go over what we're doing next month later. But there were so many shows though at the beginning where I watched one episode and then I dropped it, like Gabriel Dropout, dropped it.
Yeah.
Scum's Wish, dropped it. I'll go into more detail about that later.
All Out, I dropped that.
But that was kind of a fall holdover. That wasn't didn't start this season.
No.
But All Out was the rugby anime, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's a case of you can make sport, they can make any sport into a fucking anime. In fact, they're running out of it. They have to do Keijo, where they invented a sport. incidentally, Gintama is the only one I had. Which that had a new season this thing. I didn't watch that either.
I've not. That's one season I've never got into Gintama.
Yeah, I'm still not managed to get around to watching it. I'm a big anime fan, but I've never watched Gintama.
Yeah, it's been on my Crunchyroll list for ages now.
Yeah, same with JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, although I am really seriously planning to get around to eventually watching JoJo, because I everyone raves about Diamond is Unbreakable, and I want to watch that, and everyone's pissed off that Kira wasn't best villain. But was there... it's really been the weirdest... But in terms of the variety of shows, it's been rather weird, because there wasn't...
Yeah.
I don't think anything immediately stood out that wasn't a sequel.
Yeah.
When I think of what stood out this season, it was most of the holdovers. Like, what about the holdovers? Were we still watching any of the holdovers?
Yeah, I'm watching Iron Blooded Orphans.
Oh, yeah, you're still on season 2 of Iron Blooded Orphans. I'm about 9 episodes into that now.
The second season or first?
The second season. Okay. I finished the first season. First season's pretty good.
Yeah.
Second season, I'm kind of... Yeah, I up until kind of episode 7 or 8, I wasn't really into it. But then again, it took me a while to really get into Iron Blooded Orphans, and even then, I'm not a huge fan. They still haven't made a Gundam series that has convinced me that to be a massive Gundam fan.
Well, have I got some good news for you? G Gundam's just been greenlighted for Crunchyroll over in the States.
Well, it means it won't be too long till it's over here, then.
Exactly.
But we're already going to... You've already challenged me to watch Gundam 00.
Yeah.
We're going to be... And you won't know my thoughts on that until May. May, because it was the only month we had where there was a free slot.
Yeah.
For us to talk, because there's nothing happening in May. And yet... So, what did we think... that's kind of our thoughts... I thought it was an okay season. I don't think it was... I mean, even then, I don't think until we really reached the second half was it really an amazing season.
Yeah.
And even then, I don't think it was that amazing overall. I don't think anything I saw this... I think with two exceptions, free and an absolute push, nothing I saw this season is probably going to be a potential anime of the year for me.
I think I've got one that qualifies for me.
Okay, well, we'll go over that one when we get the chance to. But with all that, what did we think? Should we start with our OPs? What was our best OPs?
Sure.
What was your best OP?
Well, since I'm a huge mecha fan, I had to go with Iron Blooded Orphans, season 2, opening 1. Rage of Dust by Spire.
It technically counts, yes.
Yeah, because it carried over into the winter.
It carried over into the winter, I'll give you that one.
Yeah, before the second OP started.
Which I haven't actually heard the second OP, so I don't know. But yeah, that OP is really damn good.
Yeah. Instantly one of my favourites.
Yeah, I don't like it as much as Raise Your Flag, though.
No.
I think Raise Your Flag was a better opening. But then again, Man of a Mission is fantastic in terms of their opening.
Yeah, and you can't go wrong with Survivor, the second opening after.
Survivor was actually... I wasn't that much a fan of Survivor. I thought it was... Especially, but probably because it was following on from Raise Your Flag.
Yeah.
But Survivor was just there, really, for me. I was sort of like thinking, if I wasn't watching this on Crunchyroll, I would have skipped the opening. But if you try to skip an opening on a PlayStation with a PlayStation 4 controller, it's the worst thing to try and do in the world. Yeah. I just never bother. You can make the worst opening of the season, and that would be the... Absolute, and I would still watch it. It's so... it's a lot of levels that... But I liked that opening. It was a good song.
Good guitar, good vocals, just good feeling overall.
And it matched the show quite well. Yeah. I liked the sequence to go with it. I don't think Iron Blooded Orphans... I mean, we're getting far else because of EDs. I don't think Iron Blooded Orphans has done a good ED since the first one. The first one was a really great ED. Yeah. I've never really been a fan. Although I was kind of a fan of the first ED of season two. That's it. I haven't got round to the second opening and second ED. But yeah, I like them. If you had to do a runner-up with this one, because...
Well, it's a good thing I have done a runner-up. I've done two other runners-up.
Which one was those ones?
First one, the Dragon Ball Super opening two. Limit Break, Cross Survivor.
Oh, that's a good one.
That is really good.
Again, I still haven't watching Dragon Ball Super. I'm waiting for the dub. And
it's been getting really good, especially after the Goku Black arc.
I've been hearing a lot about this, and apparently Trunks is playing a big part in this, and yep. Gohan's finally getting his balls back.
Yep. Took him long enough.
It's a lot to say.
Yeah.
So I figured DBZ and Bridge. Gohan's the strongest in the universe, but still doesn't do crap. What was the other runner-up you had?
Akka 13.
Ah, Akka 13, yeah.
That is a brilliant opening.
That's my runner-up.
Really?
That was my runner-up, yeah. It was a tough call for my runner-up, because if I had to have a second runner-up, it would have been Maid Dragon.
Oh, yeah. I thought
that had a good OP, and it really matched the show properly. I mean, it's never something I'd have on my iPhone, but that's really what the one I would... that was a really good OP, and I really look forward to that every time I got down to an episode of Maid Dragon.
Yeah.
My best OP was... Konosuba.
Oh.
I loved Konosuba. I loved the opening Konosuba. It was just, this could be a mediocre episode. It doesn't matter. I've got that opening to look forward to. And that stupid dance that's going to be at every single anime con.
Yeah.
Every time. It's just, got me every time.
Yeah.
And I liked the fact that it was basically... it was an OP that that was really fit the show. I thought the first one wasn't that funny.
Yeah.
And it kind of missold you on the fact that this is a comedy.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, this is a comedy. It hasn't. And Konosuba season two was fantastic.
Yeah.
It was absolutely fantastic. But again, it was too short. There's only 10 episodes again. I mean, there's 20 episodes overall. So if you start Konosuba now, you got 20 episodes to binge on. I think that's enough. But if you were watching this episode, if you're watching these in the seasons when they premiered, like I did, you're pretty shortchanged.
Yeah. Yeah, because I found this season, the pacing on a lot of shows weren't that good.
No, the pacing on the shows was not that good either. The it's something that they carry on 2016, because I think every show in 2016 was great, but it didn't quite stick the landing.
Yeah.
With the exception of my favourite anime of last year, which was ReZero.
Yeah.
Which I think that one did stick the landing. I know a lot of people disagree with me on that one.
Yeah, I personally enjoyed it as well.
But Akka and Maid Dragon definitely my runners-up, but Konosuba was always going to be my favourite OP. I absolutely loved Konosuba. It was just freaking fantastic. It wasn't my favourite. It was close to being my favourite ED. It was a very... I liked the ED, but shall we move on to our EDs?
Yeah.
What was your favourite ED?
March Comes In Like a Lion, ending two. Orion.
You've gone for another full holdover.
I know. But it's so good.
I don't think it's a very good ED. I was It had. I think that the visuals what made that rather than the song. I don't think the song's that amazing. I think the visuals are really good. But again, it's. I was always kind of annoyed that they left the bump of chicken left after the first half. Yeah. But Marsh comes in like the line was just fantastic.
Definitely.
And I actually tweeted as soon as I watched the last episode when season two, and then about a day later they said, oh, by the way, it's coming October. Yeah. So that's gonna be definitely on my watch list for October. I loved.
Definitely something to look forward to.
Marsh comes. I mean, I will say though, I didn't like the last few episodes because the sisters didn't play a part, and the sisters are such a big part of that show, and I think they are almost put on the side. I know it's based on a manga and it has to follow the manga storyline, although there's several anime that have just said screw that in recent memory.
Yeah.
Are you in agreement with me?
Oh yeah, I completely agree.
But that's interesting because I'm tying up the scores on the thing because what is going to be declared the anime Amigo winter anime season, because at the minute we got one for Konosuba, one for Iron Blooded Orphans, and now one for March Comes in Like a Lion. So no, we've had no crossover at this point. I liked March Comes in Like a Lion for a lot of reasons, but the animation's fantastic.
Yeah.
The show has this real nice feel to it. I like the opening. I like both of the openings. I like both the endings. I think it has a bit of a tone issue as well, though.
Yeah.
You got to admit, the comedy comes a bit out of left field sometimes.
Yeah, it felt forced quite a lot, in my opinion.
Yeah, it's very, very forced. The thing is, there's a lot of drama there.
Yeah.
There's a lot of drama. There's something really to do there. So that's our picks for best. That's your pick for best thing. Starting at a crossover, but not. Did you have any runners up?
Yes, of course. Being the mecha fan I am, Iron Blooded Orphans ending one.
I knew we were going to get to that eventually, but Iron Blooded Orphans ending one, that was pretty good. I was really tossing between three for my runners up. The three I was considering were Konosuba, Koro Sensei Quest, but that's just because it's that 8-bit rendition of Song of Savage Youth, which is one of my favourite openings.
Yeah.
And I also was seriously considering, what's it called? I can't remember now. On top of my head. But those were the other two I was seriously considering. But the one I went with in the end, my best ED, was The Saga of Tanya the Evil.
Yeah.
I loved that ED. That was, I rarely stick around for the credits on a lot of things. That made me want to stick around for the credits.
Yeah, it had such good visuals in it as well.
Yeah, and they didn't have to do much with it. They just had to sort of get a picture of the main character.
Different colours.
Green, red, blue, purple. Oh, it's stupidly brilliant. It's an amazing show about it. And I just think it was a brilliant bookend. I mean, Konosuba had that nice soothing feel to it, but again, it kind of has the problem that it doesn't sell the fact it's a comedy.
Yeah.
Whereas Saga Tang Evil really fits the show really well because it's a demented little girl. What else?
I've got another runner-up.
What one?
Tales of Zestria, the X ending to Innocence by Flo.
Well, it's Flo. Of course it's going to be an amazing OP. I mean, if we're talking about full holdovers, I mean, we haven't even mentioned Twin Star Exorcist, which got its new OP and ED this season. I haven't actually seen any Twin Star because we recorded this on a Wednesday. I wanted to record it on a Thursday so that we'd be done with Maid Dragon and Twin Star Exorcist so I could talk about my thoughts on the endings of both of those shows. But if Twin Star can live up to the episode 49, I think it'll be a fantastic ending.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to go out and buy the manga so I can keep, because there's no guarantee there's going to be any more of this.
No.
Maid Dragon I really liked. Maid Dragon was pretty good. But we'll probably go into thoughts on that end of this because we can't pick Twin Star Exorcist for. I think we should go more into detail with Twin Star because we can't pick we can't pick it for our best show of anything because we made a rule. The rule is we can't pick anything from previous seasons that's carried over. So when we do our spring one, we can't then pick Little Witch Academia.
Yeah.
Even though neither of us have seen it.
No. I've got the two movies. lined up on my Netflix.
I've watched two movies on my Netflix.
What do you think of them?
I really like the movies. I'm really looking forward to the thing. Although I've really shot some of the book because I watched them in dub, which means I'm gonna. But it's a very good dub. Yeah. But it means I might be waiting a little longer than I wanted to see Little Witch Academia. I'm really looking forward to it, though. It's although I think it's a bit. I like the fact that unlike Harry Potter, we actually see him more in doing lessons and actually in school.
Yeah.
Which is. Also, I think it's a nice edit for the Harry Potter films because Harry Potter in general has gotten dark for the sake of dark, and yeah. I don't really like the whole dark for the sake of dark thing. It's just, well, it is a case of going, what are you doing? And Harry Potter, I think, is kind of going down. Luckily, Fantastic Beasts was kind of nice and was a bit more lighthearted, so that kind of helped in that. We're going well off topic now.
Definitely.
So those are our best OPs, our best EDs. So you had Konosuba, I had Iron-Blooded Orphans. Yeah. You had March Comes In Like a Lion for your best ED. I had Tanya the Evil. We're going to go over these again in a bit, but see, that's a really interesting choice. There's really interesting choices. Have we gone for a... Again, we've not really had much of a crossover, except for the Akka, we both agreed was a fantastic opening.
Yeah.
Which is saying a lot because I've not picked it for any other category. But that's not to say that I think it's a bad show. In fact, if anything, it's actually gotten much better in its second half. I haven't seen it all to the end yet because I've been watching it in simuldub. So I'm 3 episodes behind. But for me, it didn't really get amazing until episode 7-8. That was kind of when it got really good and I started paying attention to it. I didn't really pay attention to it after that.
Yeah.
Before that. So that's the. So I think we can agree there. That's that one done. Shall we go to our? Shall we move on to our biggest surprise? Was there anything? Was there much that really surprised you this season?
Well, Dragon Maid surprised me because I was just expecting, you know, typical tropes and a boring flat show. Because I wasn't expecting it to be as good as, like, Monster Musume. Which, in my opinion, it excelled.
Yeah, it's better than Monster Musume.
Yeah.
Definitely better than Monster Musume. I like Monster Musume, but I'd watch Maid Dragon any other day of the week than that. And I think... it wasn't really a surprise to me, that one. Because it was kind of... I kind of had a lot more faith in it because it was a KyoAni production. I like KyoAni productions, like Sound Euphonium and all that business. And I thought it looked like it was similar to that. I kind of like the premise. I mean, I must admit the PVs for it did not do a good job.
No.
The PVs did not do a good job of advertising. They didn't really get down what the show was going to be about. And it has that. I remember Jack from Under the Scope reviews, he said it's got that nice family feel to it. It's nice.
Yeah.
It's like a nice walk in the park.
Yeah.
It's the best way I'd describe it. Something that's the best way to describe Maid Dragon. Maid Dragon really was one of the highlights of the season for me. I absolutely. I agree with you. I absolutely loved it. I mean, I'm one episode away from finishing it tonight, but really chuffed that I got to see it. Really one of the highlights of the season for me.
Yeah, because it really just kind of left field for me.
It was. That's one of the one few I haven't that Funimation did do this season that I haven't been watching in dub. It was because I was going away to Florida around that time, so I thought no, I'm not. I'd only have one episode to catch up on, but I thought if it's going to do that anyway, I might as well watch it in sub. I'm already hearing good things about it. I didn't really start on this season until the midpoint because again I was waiting for the simuldubs, which always turns it down. Something that I'm not going to have a problem with in the spring season, judging by what Funimation's advertising. But I did watch Dragon Maid on the episode, so I'm dead chuffed I got to see all that. There wasn't a lot of surprises this season. Everything I thought was going to be good was good. Everything I thought was going to be bad was bad. There was very few actual surprises. I'm annoyed we didn't have a most disappointed category.
Yeah.
Because disappointment. What really disappointed me was an anime called Scum's Wish.
Yeah, I avoided that because it just didn't look like something that appealed to me.
It's really creepy. Yeah. I know a lot of people have said it's an interesting look at relationships and all that, and it's just, no, this is just some seriously screwed up people. that really needs some help. And I couldn't get past the first episode with it. I just could not, and I didn't want to watch it. It was the Amazon Prime exclusive anime of the season, which means a lot of people probably pirated it. Because how many of them are going to sign up for Anime Strike or have a 30-day Amazon Prime trial? And while we're on the subject, Anime Strike is probably one of the worst things to happen to the industry.
Yeah.
In a while, because I've already got an Amazon Prime account. I pay about 70 quid a year for that. And now they're expecting me to pay another £5 a month. It's not come out in the UK yet. It's still on Amazon Prime. But if I was in America, they'd expect me to pay £5 a month. And on top of that, and as far as I can tell, there's only a couple of anime on there that I couldn't get any other way.
Yeah.
That I actually want. Like the Satoshi Kon stuff and The Great Passage. I'm not paying £5 extra so I can watch Cabinary the Iron Fortress.
Yeah, it just seems really redundant.
But as for my most surprising anime, I'm going to go again for Saga of Tang of the Evil.
Yeah.
Saga of Tang of the Evil, which now is the only thing that we've said multiple times, but it's Saga of Tang of the Evil was really a brilliant show, and I was very surprised that it didn't... Oh, thanks, man. I'm really surprised. I was not surprised it was going to be good. I always thought it was going to be good. I wasn't expecting it to be I wasn't expecting it to be really good, and I wasn't expecting it to be a contender for my anime of the season. I like the whole alternate World War One thing, especially because they seem to be doing a lot of these flying girls in World Wars things, because we had Izetta the Last Witch in the fall season, which I think got a real bum rap, actually, while on the subject. I think Izetta was really good. But I remember when any time I mentioned it, everyone just said, no, it was rubbish, I dropped it after this episode, or it didn't stick to the left. Yeah, the ending's not as good as it could have been, and it wasn't my favourite of the season, but for the first half, I would say that was my best show. It was not only my best show of the season, it was a contender for anime of the year for me. And then it just didn't stick the landing.
Yeah.
But if it had stuck the landing, I would say Azessa the Last Witch would have been my best anime of 2016.
Yeah.
And incidentally, it didn't even make my top five as a result. So, well, going back to Tanya, though, I wasn't that sold in the first episode. The second episode sold me.
Yeah.
Like, that's a hell of a twist.
Yeah, because I thought it would just be like a weird show like Strike Witches.
Oh, yeah, Strike Witches, very much so. It did look like it was going to be like Strike Witches.
Yeah, lolly girls flying around with magic.
We got a World War One lolly.
Yeah.
World War One Nazi lolly. This season has a lot of, between that and Akka, this season had the kind of Nazis.
Yeah, they somehow made a comeback.
it's such a weird...
Thanks, Japan.
Japan is, it's one of those, you've got to get a shirt just saying Japan is screwed up.
Yeah.
In all honesty though, I really enjoyed this show. I mean, it's not my best of the season, but I proper liked it. I really proper liked it, and I was surprised how much I liked it. Well, did you have any? I didn't have any runners up. I honestly, there was nothing else that really surprised me.
No, because for me, it was just the most surprising was Maid Dragon.
Maid Dragon. You weren't that surprised that Tanya was as good as it was.
No, because I had a feeling it was going to be good, but it wasn't that much of a surprise that it was that good.
Yeah, whereas for me it was a lot more surprised because I really was not expecting much from it. I just thought, I saw a lot of things where people were recommending shows to begin with, and I said, alright, I'll give it a go. And then wasn't really sold with episode one, but I thought, it was only the first episode. Again, I'm not actually done with Tanya yet. I'm waiting on a few episodes. And I reserved the right with everything I'm not done with to retroactively change my mind.
Oh yeah,
in the
obviously.
Next podcast. And I think what we should do is the next podcast, which will be next month, we should actually say, if any of these shows that we're not done with, if we're going to retroactively, I don't think we'll retroactively change it, because I think these shows are pretty stuff. I mean, you've got ahead of me on Tiny Evil. Was there any major drop in quality after episode 9?
No, I think it stayed really good till the end.
Well, I'm going to stick with it then. So that's our biggest surprises. I think it's now time to move on. What's our best sequel?
Well, mine was Blue Exorcist.
Blue Exorcist, really?
Yeah. Because I liked it, because it did a bold move at the start of season two that a lot of people weren't happy about following up from season one, but I think it worked in the end.
Oh god, I'm not looking forward to this now because I know it's
so it's one of those you have to stick with it. I know this beginning sounds pretty. I didn't really hear much about this one because I wanted to avoid Blue Exorcist as much as possible because I wanted to wait for the dub and check it out. Now I'm considering I might say screw that and watch it in sub on that basis because, did you watch the first season in sub?
Yeah.
Well, Netflix had to have the dub for my thing, so I was just getting a Netflix account, so I wanted to go with that. And incidentally, Netflix, get on releasing Little Witch Academia because we couldn't pick it for this category. We probably might retroactively change our minds and say... Yeah. Little Witch Academia gets this prize. What about... was there any... we'll go over our runners-up in a minute because I might end up picking one of your runners-up. I don't think I do, judging by the conversations we've had leading up to this. That was the thing. With Blue... the thing is, I'm nervous to ask you about anything with Blue Exorcist because I don't know... what your thoughts were on that one, but...
Well, I'll say this. I enjoyed it, and I advise people to stick with it.
So if your voice is, if they dropped it, go back, try it again, because it actually does get good. I think that's what I was saying a lot of people when they start with ReZero. Stick with it, it gets amazing by the end.
Yeah.
But then again, ReZero, we all thought it was pretty good at the start, and then we kind of dipped, and then it kind of lowered itself down. We all thought this is good, but we're not quite convinced. And then it kind of got to the second half and like, yeah, we love this. This will be the most popular anime of the year. Oh wait, no, there goes. There's a guy figure skating in the distance. No, that's the most popular anime of the year. Let's give it every single Crunchyroll award we can give it. What did you vote for best anime in Crunchyroll awards?
I didn't yet go for Yuri on Ice.
You went for Yuri on Ice?
Solely for the memes people were saying of. It's not gay enough, or it's too gay.
And yeah, incidentally, there was a lot of anime about gay characters in the fall, because there was also Flip Flappers in Nezeta.
Yeah.
Although those were more undertones, although Nezeta's only case because they didn't actually kiss. That's your best sequel.
Yeah.
My best sequel, there was a two-horse race for me.
Okay.
Obviously, I didn't see Blue Exorcist because I'm for obvious the reasons I've already mentioned. But there was a two-horse race for me. So, but my best by about the midpoint, I thought it was going to take it. Although I still was still in competition. But by the end of the by the time the show's reached about episode nine, I realized no, it's got to be this one. And that was Showa Genroku Rakugo Shinju season two, or Descending Stories Showa Genroku Rakugo Shinju. I just loved this show to pieces.
Yeah.
I love this show to pieces. It's so amazing. It should have won Best Drama at the Crunchyroll Awards. This show is just fantastic. And I was really nervous about the second season. I thought, okay, you've done the flashback story. That's all said and done. There's nowhere else to go with it. What can you go with this one? Is that how much can we get out of the modern day? Well, I think it's modern day. Because they kind of do but again, I don't really want to talk about that because I don't want to avoid spoilers, especially with this show, because it's so good and there's a big... what I liked about this season, though, was it took something that we established... It took a lot of things that we established about the first season and then turned it on our heads.
Yeah.
Did you watch much Rakugo?
Not that much, unfortunately. I've been meaning to get back to it,
though. Seriously, get back to it. This one, I think, is going to become one of the great anime dramas. I think in about 2 or 3 years' time... People are going to say this one's essential viewing. It's just fantastic. And you could never dub this show.
Yeah.
You could never dub it. I don't see how you do the Rakugo scenes. If you dub it. It's probably one of the most Japanese shows I've seen. Because a lot of anime, you get a sense of, yeah, it's very Japanese, but it's also got a bit of this influence here, this influence there. Rakugo, it's 100% Japan.
Yeah.
That's the best way to quote it. It's 100% Japan. There's nothing about it that's got any sort of Western influence. Did you have it? My runner-up, incidentally, was the one that was convincing people was Konosuba.
Yeah.
Because those were the two. I just looked forward every week. There was Konosuba, and Wednesday was Konosuba, Friday was Rakugo. It was like, yeah, I'm going to have some fun. and then I'm going to watch the serious drama.
Yeah. Kona Super was my runner-up, incidentally.
Oh, Kona Super was your runner-up? Yeah. I'm guessing it didn't win because... it didn't win because there was too few episodes, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Well, is Blue Exorcist still going on? Is that carrying on into the...
Yeah, it's still going on now.
It's going to carry on to the spring?
Yeah, should do.
Sweet. So they're going for 24, 25 episodes again?
Yeah, I think so.
That's pretty good. Again, you might end up, if it doesn't stick the landing, you might end up changing your mind and going back and saying, actually, Kona Super really was the best. Either way, it probably won't affect our decision making. So you won't.
Yeah, and I'm saying that if you enjoyed the manga of Blue Exorcist, you'll be happy with season two.
I haven't read the manga of it yet. Right. Did the first season go off the manga?
Yeah, towards the end it spiralled off quite a bit.
So this swing's kind of desperately trying to drag it back to the...
Yeah.
So it's
swing you like a pendulum.
Incidentally, I've heard ReZero went a bit off with the ending of the light novels, and they're going to try and... they reckon if there's ever a season two, they're going to try and drag it back to the light novels. Although, that being said, I love the ending of ReZero.
Yeah. Yeah, it was just brilliant.
Yeah, even though there's that meme at the end of it, that's hilarious. So, that's our best sequels. What was your pick for best original? So we're doing best original series now. This was, we actually had a discussion about Little Witch Academia, which again we will say whether we were able to actually change our minds when we eventually get around to see it. Incidentally, it turned up on Netflix this morning just before I came here.
Did it?
Yeah. There's no episodes, but they've got a listing of it on Netflix now. So it is something. So Netflix are definitely going to do it. They're still listing it as a Netflix original. I'm always amazed that they do that with the Netflix stuff because they never finance it directly. It's not like Seven Deadly Sins has that, but they not finance that.
Yeah, which I always find weird about Netflix that they notify you of stuff you don't care about, and when they should be reminding you of like the anime that's coming out. Because a great example is After Earth.
Oh yeah.
I got a notification saying, you will like this. I was like,
No, you won't.
Well, yeah, tell me when Seven Deadly Sins is out, then come back to me.
We got the Seven Deadly Sins OVA actually this season as well. I got to watch that. That was hilarious. That was brilliant.
Yeah, I really enjoyed that.
Brilliant. I mean,
it's a great follow up.
I'm looking forward to season two, which will be they're reckoning it might be coming out fall this year, although since it's Netflix, we probably won't be seeing it until 2018.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Yeah, but Amazon's kind of bad about that as well. There was very little advertising for Cavernary the Iron Fortress. Now, that being said, Cavernary, from what I heard, didn't turn out to be an amazing anime, but that was still a really hyped up show based on a very popular manga. You should be bloody advertising that.
Yeah.
So, we're kind of on that roll. Original seasons. There wasn't a lot of great original seasons. I had a bit of trouble with this one.
Well, I had a bit of trouble, and so I went back and rewatched Aka 13.
Aka 13's your best.
Yeah, my best original.
Your best original.
I really enjoyed the geopolitical drama and the undertones to every character.
You have to admit, though, with the first few episodes, it was kind of. Is there going to be a point to any of this?
That's
kind of the feeling I got. When you decide to have a point to all of this, let me know.
Yeah, whereas I really enjoyed the slow build-up, expanding on the characters, seeing what's going on behind the scenes and people's plans.
And then when the twist finally came, it was actually felt like it had been built up pretty well. I agree, it didn't get great until about episode 7, 8.
Yeah.
That's all time. That's when...
The major twist happens,
and it's properly fun.
Yeah.
Incidentally, it's probably one of political dramas, there's so few and far between with anime.
Yeah.
I really liked Aka by the end of it, but I don't even say it would be my top. I think it would be my top three now than the last part, because a lot of shows that started out good then kind of went downhill for me, like Fuka started out pretty good, but then I kind of lost interest.
Yeah, because that was number one, most people was disappointed.
I don't get why, it's not that bad. It's not great, but it's not that bad. I mean, the music could be a little bit better. better. And incidentally, if there ever is a fictional band called the Hedgehogs, you've got the worst name of any band ever. And I'm saying that when there's an artist called Owl City. And I'm saying the Hedgehogs sounds worse. It sounds like a name for that Sonic Underground band.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I saw a review for that the other day. It was so... Because it turned up on the list of worst cartoons based on video games lists.
In my opinion, it wasn't that bad. But I think it definitely should have actually finished instead of being cancelled.
Yeah, it did follow... It was following on from Sat AM, which... Yeah. That was always going to be a tough shoe to fill. And Sat AM, I mean... A lot of people say it ended. I say it didn't end. The comic was the continuation. The comic was the logical place it was going. So I'd say the vision never died.
Yeah.
But, well, incidentally, the comics suck now.
Yeah, ever since they got rebooted.
Yeah, while we're at it, screw you, Ken Penders.
Yeah.
Screw you. You were being a right selfish tosser for that one.
Yeah. No doubt about that.
Akko was probably one of my runners-up. But that was only because of the last few episodes. I was actually considering dropping it for a while.
Really?
I seriously was considering dropping it. Around sort of episode 4, I was saying, where is this going? This is going nowhere. And, but I had a free time. I was like, oh, I have a free time. I'm not watching anything else in Funimation. I've got 3 episodes built up. Let's watch them. And then crap, I'm now going to keep watching this.
Yeah, because it was really good, because it made you engage as a viewer.
There's no... The manga's still not been released over here.
No.
And from what I heard, the manga's ongoing, so... And again, I don't know the ending of it, but I'm presuming that it's got a bit of a to-be-continued ending.
Yeah, because I've heard that it's really good.
Yeah, as I say, though, it looks like it's got some interesting art in it. And again, it kind of stands out in terms of the drawings and the designs.
Yeah.
Although it's very distinctively anime. It's not like it's gone off the rails on anime.
Yeah, and it was done by one of my favourite studios, Studio Madhouse.
Madhouse is a really great studio. Yeah, that that Madhouse was pretty much the reason I watched it in the first place.
Yeah, same actually.
Yeah, because you go through the list and you look, well, what studio's doing this? And it's where's the Kyoto Animation production? Where's the Madhouse production? Where's the Trigger production?
Yeah.
There's no Trigger production for next month because the next season because they're still doing Academia.
Yeah.
Well, again, that's going to be a 2 meetings next month, but we're going to go into that in a bit. It wasn't my best, but incidentally, my best was a Funimation dub.
Okay.
And it's one I'm also not done with. It's Interview with Monster Girls.
That's a series I've not watched.
I really... are you into... Do you like slice of life anime? I mean, proper slice of life anime. Not much drama. It's just day-to-day living and sort of like really getting into enjoying spending time with characters.
In my opinion, stuff like that can drag on.
It can drag on. This one doesn't quite have that effect. It's not like Flying Witch where I thought, yeah, this is very good, but it's kind of dragging on. That was... I think when these ones are done right, they're done right. And again, this one's only 12 episodes, and they're paced very well. Which is, again, I think the mistake Flying Witch made.
Yeah.
Although, again, don't get me wrong, I actually liked Flying Witch. Don't kill me don't kill me in the comments section. I actually genuinely like Flying Witch. I've even pre-ordered the first volume of the manga, which is coming out in the UK soon. But, no, with every original series I saw this season, I didn't want to go out and get the source material. I didn't want to make sure I could continue the story. Monster Girls, I bought the first 3 volumes. I have all the other volumes on pre-order. Because I really liked this show. And I liked it a lot more than I was expecting it to. But again, I was expecting it to be one of my favourites.
Yeah.
Because it looked like it had my kind of thing. I liked slice of life anime. I really liked Amachu and Sweetness and Lightning last year. To a certain extent, Beck Mongolian Chop Squad's kind of a slice of life anime. And that's one of my all-time favourites. In fact, if we could extend it out to a 10 list, Beck would definitely be in that list. I'm really glad that all the anime has actually rescued it.
Yeah.
Rescue the license, because I was really worried that was going to fade into obscurity, but I just loved interviewing Monster Girls. It was really a fun show, but it's about a biology teacher who lives in this world where there's sort of humans and demi, what's called demi-humans, like vampires and all that. But so he discovers that one of the teachers is succubi.
Right.
But trust me, it's not. You're thinking you're going to get a lot of fan service jokes. No, you're not. There's actually very, very little to no fan service in this show, which is pretty good considering the ages of the gods in this. It's not one of these animes where if this was real, if this was a live action show, we'd all be on the sex offenders register. Like First Love Monster. Jesus Christ, what was up with that show? Like, you got. I know about the age of consent laws in Japan, but you've got some issues there. And he then discovers also three students are also demi-humans. Like, one of the girls is a vampire, one's a Dullahan, or the headless, type, and one's a snow woman, which is actually a thing. It's a bit like Elsa in Frozen, but it's based on Japanese. That was very Japanese in its origins, very Japanese. And he sort of slowly goes to understand them and learn them, and he creates a group of them to be a group so that they can learn from one another. There's some good comedy in it. I liked the OP and the ED aren't much to write home about, which is why they didn't really turn up on my list. But in terms of shows I look forward to every week, nothing I look more forward to watching than the Interview with Monster Girls in terms of original series. And again, I'm not done with it. I'm watching on simuldub because I should explain I'm very, very dyslexic, so it's much easier for me to watch a dub than a sub. Incidentally, I was really pissed off with Gundam Iron Blooded Orphans because I watched the first. I didn't know about the dub until I was done with the first season, and I didn't even. And I thought, oh well, I'll be reserved for the deep. And then when I found out about it, I was sort of halfway through the first season when I first saw that it was done. I thought, no, it's no point now. And anyway, they'll probably be reserved for a DVD, so I'll go back and watch that later. But then I discovered, and then I went to play the next episode because I thought, oh, I'll start season two now. And then I saw the first episode in dub, and then I saw it was the first episode in dub, and I'm like, oh, damn it! Damn it, no! I could have watched the first season in dub!
Yeah, but the first season did take a while to dub, though.
Because that when was that done? It was 2015, that was.
Yeah.
What took you? But Daisuke still hold the light. I think that's Putin tunneling in. That joke is, it's a copyright Ian Hislop from I Got News For You. Episode, I don't know, who cares. I loved the show. I thought that it was just fantastic. I really like Monster Girls. I think Monster Girls has a real quality to it that I think could go for a second season.
Yeah.
It's again, very much a slice of life anime. It's very much, very episodic. Although it has, unlike most slice of life anime, the good slice of life anime knows to keep a little bit of an overarching plot. Like in Amachu, it's her moving to the new town, joining the scuba club, and eventually leading up to doing her first dive. And before you call me out for spoilers, they practically signposted that that's going to happen in the opening. So if you didn't get that, I'm sorry. But really. And yeah, for my money, that was just the best one. I absolutely loved that. I know I'm not going to go as far as I absolutely love that show, but that's the only one I'm actually really considering for anime of the year in my list. And I know a lot of people didn't really rate it that highly. It was really rated highly at the beginning of the season. Then they did. Now, we didn't really see anything awful this season. Did we see anything that was really awful?
Not really awful.
I heard Handshakers was awful, but
yeah, I don't watch that.
I didn't even start with that one. I was considering starting with it on dub, but then I heard the critical response to it, and I just said I'm not for it. And incidentally, who named it Handshakers? That's just you're setting up the meme and the joke before you even start. It's one of those, just it's that you want to cut to that clip from The Fresh Prince where Uncle Phil says too easy.
Which incidentally is also on Netflix now.
Oh yeah, Fresh Prince is on Netflix, and it's on Comedy Central as well.
Yeah.
I love The Fresh Prince.
Same. I loved it as a kid.
So it's a pity I'm not rubbish at editing, because I do after the vlog, I just do a shot where you get thrown out.
Yeah, but I'm always wearing the same t-shirt, so you know I'm watching the episodes.
It was always great, because like, he's wearing the shirt, he's going to get thrown out. And of course, there was just that, but apparently that first take was so amazing they had to keep doing it every time.
Well, it was a cost-saving measure.
Oh, yeah, because of course they didn't have a lot. Whether they not have the money to make that? Quincy Jones was producing it. This guy managed Michael Jackson, for God's sake, and you can't spring a few bob for this. For Christ's sake. Although from what I've heard, that first take was so perfect they had to keep doing it. But, so, what were your runners-up for Best Original Season? Was there any runners up?
I didn't really have any runners up, surprisingly.
Not Saga Tanya the Evil? Or would you just say that was a bit surprising but you wouldn't really rate it?
Yeah, really surprising. Because otherwise there'd be an overlap between most surprising and best original season.
Oh, well, I'm about to overlap because I'm going to say that was my runner-up.
Then I'd have to put it as my runner-up.
So we're both agreed Saga Tanya the Evil was the second place
this
season. But the minute we've given it the most, because we've given it our... I put it best surprise, best ED, and we kind of said it was runner-up in a lot of things.
Yeah, it was a really good standout season.
So I think at the minute we probably might have to say that was the animated season, because it's the only thing we kind of agreed on so far.
Overall, it's what we agree on.
I think we should declare right now, I think we should declare our winter season anime was Saga Tanya the Evil, because it's the only thing we really ultra agree on. But I think we should reserve the right to change our mind. Or do we want to go with Akka? Because Akka we both kind of agreed on as well. I'm really disappointed we're not going to go for an interview with Monster Girls, because you had to not watch it.
Okay, well, I promise you this, I'll watch it for the next vlog.
Well, save it for May, okay?
Yeah.
Let's agree by May you will have seen all of it. And do you have a Funimation account?
No.
Right, so you're watching it sub then.
Yeah.
Which is great, because you can watch it all now, you can binge watch it now, because it's all the 12 episodes are done. No, I loved everything about that season, but I agree. So we're going to go with Tanya or Akka for the Anime Amigo anime of the season. This is going to be really hard when we do the spring one, because there's going to be three of us.
Yeah, I say Tanya.
Yeah, I'm going to go for Tanya as well. I think so that's agreed. The Anime Amigo anime of the season, of the winter 2017 season, is Saga Tanya the Evil, and that's going to go forward to our debate for anime of the year.
Yeah. Definitely.
Although I think with Anime of the Year, when we do that in January, I think we should each have a top 5 or top 10 list.
Yeah.
And then we should discuss the 4 that we put forward. But can we agree that we... No. We want it to be an original show that wins Anime of the Year. So I was going to say, can we agree that if Little Witch Academia is really good, when we see it, we can change our minds to that. But I don't think we should have a sequel be Anime of the Year, because they've already got an advantage of an audience.
Yeah, exactly.
It's why I would never have had Diamond is Unbreakable up. I might see Diamond is Unbreakable. But that's a prime example, because everyone would say that was a contender for Anime of the Year last year. I was like, no, it isn't. JoJo's already got a guaranteed audience.
Yeah.
Incidentally, I think we should move forward now. What's spring going to be like? Spring.
Okay.
What do we reckon spring's going to be like?
For original, I think it's looking good for spring.
Yeah, that's a lot of... I mean, I've got the list here of everything that's coming out in spring season on my anime list, and it's... just looking amazing. I mean, I'm already seeing about 10, 15 shows I want to watch.
Yeah. Now, mine's going to be a controversial choice for most looking for original. And that should be Yu-Gi-Oh! Reigns.
That's not original, that's a sequel.
No, it's standalone. Because it's coming
out. Yeah, but it's based on a previous franchise. We agree Little Witch Academia is a sequel, but that's not...
but that's continuing directly from the... It's standalone.
Alright, fine, you can have that one. But you have to have another runner-up now to get balance it out for my rules.
Okay, continuing, you probably won't like this, but Gundam Thunderbolt.
Gundam Thunderbolt? No, I heard a lot of good things about Gundam Thunderbolt.
Really good.
Is there an original series that's completely original that you're really looking forward to next season? Because I'm seeing a lot here that I like the look of.
Nothing really caught my eye, I'd say.
I would say Clockwork Planet should be one you should look out for.
Yeah, I saw that. It's interesting.
It's the guy doing No Game No Life. Incidentally, and it's turning up in my next loot anime. It hasn't turned up yet. The craze about the future, but it means I'll probably have a ghost. I'm betting I'll have a Ghost in the Shell or Eyes shirt for seeing the movie, which we'll go into detail in a minute on our plans for that, because we can't have an anime vlog and not address Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah.
Getting a live action movie.
Better off or worse.
You're not going in with high hopes, are you?
No. Because let's face it, every other anime adaptation or video game adaptation has not been good.
Yeah, but I think with anime adaptations, there's not been the confidence behind it. I think that's been the big difference I get with this time. I get with the interviews this time, there's a lot more confidence in the property. And DreamWorks has had this license for a while. They've clearly hung on to it. And it seems like they're really genuinely quite interested in... making a good movie. I think it won't be, basically, it won't be because it's a bad, I think if it's a bad movie, it won't be for the lack of intention of making a good movie. And let's face it, the trailers do look like it's going to capture the look and feel.
Yeah.
But, well, at least the look of Ghost in the Shell. I'm not sure it will capture the feel, because I don't remember Depeche Mode being a big part of... But no, my most... a clover plant I'm really looking forward to. I'm really looking forward to an... I'm trying to get the name right here. It's an anime called Sekai no Yami Zakan. And it's going to be a horror anthology anime. So it's going to be like Night Gallery and Twilight Zone. Every episode is going to be a different story and a different theme. And it's all going to be horror-based. I love the idea. I mean, I'm really a big fan of the Night Gallery and anthology horror. Because I think you're allowed to do a lot more with the characters and a lot more with the ideas. And it really trusts your creative ability when you can just do it in one go.
Yeah.
So for my money, I would say it's probably the most one of the things I'm most looking forward to. I'm really looking forward to Clockwork Planet, even though I thought No Game, No Life was a bit overrated. There's a show called Recreators that I like the look of. A lot of romance anime out next season as well.
Yeah, that's why I noticed.
Yeah, I like... I said at the beginning, I like Clannad, so that's already telling you what my thoughts on that one. I like this Fuken Neke Noise, which looks like it's going to be good. But for my money, the thing I'm most looking forward to is My Hero Academia Season 2, which starts on Saturday. And we're both going to be watching that at the same time. You're going to be watching on Crunchyroll on sub. I'm going to be watching Funimation on dub.
Yeah.
So so we're probably going to have this... I mean, did you ever watch the dub of the first season of Academia?
No.
It's a really good dub. Like, Chris Sabat is perfectly cast as... is someone hoovering out there?
That's what it sounds like.
Oh, God, we're going to have audio... thank God the microphone's facing this way. We're going to have massive... Apologies if there's audio issues here. We really... This was the only building we could both get to film in. But I loved Academia Season 1. Academia Season 1 was it was number 2 on my best anime of the year last year. But I proper, and the dub is excellent. Jason Brightman's pretty good. I think it's Jason Brightman who plays Deku. He's a really good choice. Everyone's a pretty good choice, and it's they can deliver the comedy and the action pretty well. I think Academia Season 2, I've read a little bit of the manga. I was not intending to go beyond season 1, but the third volume of the manga is actually a bit of a bridge gap between season 1 and season 2. So you'll get an idea of what the first few episodes are going to be like of season 2 if you read the third volume of the manga. And incidentally, I'm going to continue with the manga after it's done, because I suspect season 2 will be the last season. I don't know. Maybe I'm hoping it's going to be like JoJo, and we'll get a new one every year. I genuinely think Academia should have done a 24 episode season, and then we would have had 13 episodes every other year.
Yeah.
Because then it would have kept, because it's a very long running show now. Like, there's a lot of potential for where it's going to go. I mean, it's like the best way I've always described to people is saying it's like a Marvel Cinematic Universe film done as an anime.
Yeah, it's really well done.
Although it's kind of ripping off the plot of Sky High.
Yeah,
it's basically, and every time I always say to people when that's why I kind of go with it. I always go with the Marvel Cinematic Universe because every time I say, have you ever seen Sky High? Yeah. No, they haven't seen it.
Or if you did, you were drunk.
I saw it on a plane actually.
I did as well, actually.
It's something really weird when we're both flying back from Greece at the same time.
No, I was flying back from Jamaica.
I liked the film Sky High. I think it's a very underrated film, but Academia just does it so much better, mainly because Deku is a very likeable protagonist.
Yeah.
He's that, and he's probably my 10 favourite superheroes now. I like him that much. I mean, I'm really glad he won Best Hero of the Crunchyroll Awards. The only time I voted for two of them and they actually won the award, I voted for Deku for Best Hero and Rem won Best Girl.
Yeah.
And Rem is Best Girl.
Yeah.
And that being said, I don't hate Amelia. I was actually watching this saying, even these two could end up with him and I'll be happy.
Yeah.
Because it didn't feel kind of weird around the middle that he suddenly switched from Amelia to Rem.
Yeah. I'm not sure if it was a bit forced for the narrative.
Yeah. Those two are now going to be the subject of every Would You Rather game in a bit amongst anime fans. I'm looking forward to London Anime Con now. but that's, I think that's really what we, neither of us on Titan?
Because personally, I didn't enjoy the first season that much.
I really liked the first season. I so much like when I got the manga ahead of time. I said, I'm not waiting. And I knew this was going to take ages before they'd actually make a second season. I said, I'm not waiting 3 or 4 years to see where this story goes. I have to know what's in the basement. Incidentally, I now know what is in the basement. And it's I'm hoping they get to that point in season two.
Yeah, because I got that title wasted. I looked up on Wikipedia what was in the basement.
Yeah, it's wow. I did not see that one coming.
And it is a good twist.
It's a very good twist. So if you're waiting for Attack on Titan season two, we really are going to recommend it. Are you going to watch season two, incidentally?
I'll give it a watch.
But you're free to drop it if you want. Yeah. I mean, did you watch in sub or dub the first time?
Sub.
Yeah, did you watch mostly subs? Is there ever a time when you actually choose to watch a dub?
Mainly just when the dub's available.
Yeah.
And I haven't seen the subs.
No, I'm a bit of a weird one. I can't watch it when I have another language. But I mean, it's probably going to be a while till I ever watch the dub of Maid Dragon. It'll be whenever I get a girlfriend, and she says, "Oh, what's it like?" And I'll say, "I'll watch that." And then I'll say, "Well, can we watch it in dub? Because I haven't seen it in dub yet, and I really want to know what it's like." It's very weird because not much KyoAni gets dubbed. There's very few KyoAni dubs. Like, the only one I can pick off the top of my head is Clannad.
Yeah. Not really a big dub-centred series,
company. Are they? No, well, again, they run themselves very differently than other anime companies because they actually hire out... They actually have a hired staff rather than go to a load of freelancers. One I forgot to mention is also there's a few sequels. And one sequel that was meant to come out next one, but it's not anymore, was Blood Blockade Battlefront Season 2.
Yeah.
Well, if they're added Academia to Crunchyroll, then surely we're going to get Blood Blockade Battlefront soon. But apparently that's coming in the fall now.
Yeah.
I mean, are you looking forward to that one?
Sure. I just hope it's not some trouble with the production side of things that made me push back.
Personally, if it's a production issue, I'm glad they pushed it back now.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm looking more forward to that than One Punch Man Season 2. Again, don't kill me, I actually do like One Punch Man. I do like One Punch Man.
Whereas I really like One Punch Man. I can't wait for that to come out.
Is that your most anticipated thing this year?
Yeah. It's, again,
you and me, it's going to be Deku versus Saitama. That could be a future V-Log. Who's the better, Deku or Saitama? Which Saitama's going to win every time. Because Deku could probably hold him off for one punch, and then he's not got the next punch.
Yeah.
But then again, you never know. He might expand this season. The next season. Mm-hmm. Incidentally, the only other thing really to talk about is A Silent Voice, because that came out in the UK this month.
Yeah.
And did you go and see it?
No. Because I pretty much have no free cash.
Incidentally, you're going to need some free cash if you want to take part in the next one, because I've already told you what the subject is for the next one. Silent Voice, I did go and see it. I've already sort of set up my text review of it because I'm doing a whole load of text reviews for the website I'm on. So I won't go into too much detail, but I absolutely loved it. I absolutely loved it. I don't think it was as good as Your Name.
Yeah.
But man, was this a good film? It's like a KyoAni production done. The animation's amazing. It's like KyoAni production is done through a watercolor painting. That's what I say. The characters are great. I love the cinematography. I love the voice actors they chose to play the parts. They're all pretty damn good. Again, they played the sub version. And there's another anime movie coming out in June the 30th. I forgot what its name is off the top of my head, but I saw a trailer for it in cinemas. And I wish I had my iPad on me because I keep a whole list of the films I'm going to be seeing. But that's incidentally what I thought. But that's what I thought of Silent Voice. I just thought it was fantastic. It's probably going to be my film of the year, I reckon. I reckon it will definitely be in my top 10. And this is the thing. I took a guy who works for me, Scott, I took him to go and see it with me because the trains were having a lot of trouble around that time.
Yeah.
Because there's no cinema in Chester, so I have to go take a train to Liverpool, Manchester, to Manchester to see Sword Art Online next month. I basically drove me there. He doesn't watch anime a lot, but he absolutely loved it. So it's going to have a real universal appeal. I think Mark Kermode's... I think if you want a good review of it, go see Mark Kermode's review of it. He doesn't actually play any clips because it's all in Japanese, and obviously that doesn't work as well on the radio for the point. But And the other thing to talk about is also, I would say get it. You can pre-order it on Amazon, actually. It's on Amazon, I've already pre-ordered it, but it's not coming out until December. So we're going to be waiting a while so we get your thoughts on it.
Yeah.
That will move on to the fall 2017 podcast. Because I was saying, we're going to do June's going to be spring, September's summer.
Yeah.
And we're going to do the fall and December. Although with the fall one, we're both going away for Christmas.
Yeah.
So we won't have seen everything. We won't have seen everything to the end when we do the fall one. So it's going to be our best guesswork on what will be the best. And then we'll decide when we do our best and worst of the year lists.
Yeah, but I'll tell you about another show neither of us have mentioned coming up. Boruto,
yes! I'm not sure if I'm going to watch that yet. I'm very far behind on Naruto. Because when it comes to the big three, I'm One Piece.
Yeah.
And which one are you in the big three?
Probably Naruto.
See, that's interesting. And Ren's Bleach. So that could be a future episode. We could have all three of us debating on. Because you're Naruto, I'm One Piece, and he's Bleach. Yeah. So that's interesting.
It shows the trifecta.
We're all three parts of the trifecta. And internet, do we think there's ever going to be a fourth anime to join that list, or a fourth or a fifth or something like that, or will there be another three?
I'd say the closest one, that's probably Gintama.
Gintama's probably the closest. I think Academia might join it one day. If Academia gets the number of episodes, JoJo might also join it one day, I reckon.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Because that's kind of in its infancy, but it's looking like it's going to be, it's sort of set up to be a show like that.
Yeah.
And again, I'm saying that without actually ever seeing any episodes of it. But I promise you I'm going to watch it. I promise you it's in my queue. I've got a few, but you've already challenged me to watch Gundam 00.
Yep.
Which I think at the minute might be our May episode, because you want to convince me that Gundam is the greatest thing to happen to anime.
Yeah.
And I keep telling you, I'm just not that into it. I'm just not. With the exception of one season, with the exception of Gundam Wing, I'm just not that into it.
Yeah, whereas I'm just like the biggest
Gundam nut you'll ever meet.
Yeah, because my room's just plastered with Gunpla everywhere.
Incidentally, one of the first things I got when I got Loot Anime was a Gundam figurine.
Really?
I'll get up the past crates thing on my Loot, on the Loot crate thing. This is a very professional talk amongst yourselves from me.
I'm sure Dream could just edit this bit out.
I'll do it. Oh no, he ain't gonna edit shit. I'm also keen. We're gonna avoid. The main reason I want to make this a vlog rather than anything massively edited is because there's no fair use law in Japan.
Yeah.
So if we didn't do it like this, we're running a really heavy gamut. How do you access the pass? Oh, here we go. Pass crates. Incidentally, if you want to get the crates, next month is, they've already looked at next month is, the theme's Humanity, and it's Attack on Titan, the only thing I've actually seen that's in it. The other two are Black Lagoon and,
Oh, you've never seen Black Lagoon?
No, I haven't, I've got the DVDs on pre-order.
Oh.
No, I've got the DVDs on order, but they're really bloody rare.
Yeah, because I really enjoyed Black Lagoon. It's on Netflix.
Tell me it's not in dub on Netflix. Tell me it's not in dub on Netflix.
I'm not sure.
Oh, Christ. Well,
yeah, because it's on there. Second Barrage is on there. And the OVAs are on there as well.
Excellent. Just excellent. I'm an idiot.
Yeah, because one show we mean to get around to watching is Tokyo Ghoul.
Oh, okay. Netflix. I like Tokyo Ghoul.
Yeah,
although the second season kind of blows.
I'm not sure if the second season's on there, or if it's just the first.
You can get the second season on DVD. Anyway, there we go. The theme was Squadron. It was from Gundam Assault Kingdom. It was a Gundam Assault Kingdom figurine. It was the main Gundam from that. There you got. And that, It was great, because that was the only thing I actually recognised in the crate that time, because I hadn't seen, Gate, I hadn't seen Anti-Magic Academy, Bay Fifth. What else was in that crate? It was...
Yeah, I just saw Gate.
Oh, Arpeggio Blue Steel was also in that crate. Again, I haven't seen it, because they gave me the manga in that crate. And I read the first volume and I thought this is something that works much better as an anime than it does as a manga.
Well, if you want to watch anything about Japanese propaganda, watch Gate.
Yeah, Gate, it's really...
Yeah, it's like, Japan is amazing, we have the best force
in the world, even though we haven't committed a conflict in years. I think they're very pacifist after World War II, but there's that thing about, you ever see that clip, the guy tried to sign the thing to say Japan could be used to aid other conflicts?
Yeah,
And there was a nut, and another guy who was a complete pacifist literally leaped onto the thing to try and stop him from signing it, and it was a massive pile-up.
Yeah.
Pile-up. There was a lot of people in Japan that were seriously scared of the idea that they were going to go into conflict, and they still feel that hold up from World War II, not helped by the fact that movies like Ray of the Fireflies exist, which kind of reminds people of, although incidentally I actually am with Ben at the stage on that one, I actually don't think it's a good film. I never thought it was a good film. I always thought from a
film. I enjoy the themes it tries to portray.
But at the same time, those themes are very manipulative and don't really work as a whole.
Yeah.
So that was our thoughts on the winter season. Just to recap, your best OP was, I've got the list here.
So, Calvin.
See how professional and prepared we are in this vlog. Your best OP was Iron Blooded Orphans.
Yep.
Your best ED was March Comes In Like a Lion.
Yep.
Your biggest surprise was Me Dragon. Your best sequel was Blue Exorcist.
Yep.
And your best original was Akka.
Yep.
And my best OP was Konosuba. My best ED was Sarutang the Evil. My best biggest surprise was Sarutang the Evil. My best sequel was Shogun Roku Rakugo Shinju, and my best original series was Interview with Monster Girls, and between us we agreed the anime of the season was Saga of Tanya the Evil.
Yeah.
How did we come to that conclusion? It's like incidentally we look at the list and it's Saga of Tanya the Evil really rarely turned up, and then we suddenly decide it's the anime of the season.
Well, it was the season series that we both really enjoyed.
But at the same time, yeah. It'll be interested to see what will happen when three of us do it next time.
Yeah. If it's just going to turn into a massive fight.
And we'll have more War Scrolls next time, because I've ordered a couple more to come for it, and you've already reserved the One Punch Man one.
Yeah.
But I now think I should have done One Piece, Bleach, and Naruto now, so we'd have had those three, each one behind us. But, so that's our picks, that's our thoughts on the season.
Yep.
Pretty good season, all things considered.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
It wasn't a dumpster fire we were going to expect, it wasn't that great a season, I think it was just an okay season.
Yeah. Okay, good.
But considering that everything's happened, especially for us in England, we're nowhere near London, but everything that's happened, just to have those small pickups is just worth it. I mean,
yeah.
We're living in the age of Brexit and Donald Trump, and that's what gets us through the day. And if we only had a few series that got us through that, it was a worthwhile season in my book.
Definitely.
And I Interview Monster Girls probably going to, and Tanya the Evil probably going to be in my best of the year list. Although I'm not saying that for now, it's spring and summer. It might be none of the winter shows make my best of the year. That means said Shogun Roku Rakugo Shinju will stay with me forever after that. But next month we're going to be talking about Ghost in the Shell and Sword Art Online. We're not just going to be talking about the films, we're going to be talking about our thoughts on the franchise as a whole. So we're obviously not going to mention what our thoughts are now on both of those, because we obviously want something to talk about in the next one.
Yeah.
But what are your thoughts? But let's go into our thoughts going into those films. What are you feeling going into Ghost in the Shell?
I'm going in with tempered expectations.
Yeah, same here. Tempered expectations. It does look like it's going to be a bit of a rehash of everything that we've already seen in live action. Although I hope it's better than that.
Yeah. Same.
Incidentally, we will warn you in advance when we're going into spoilers on both of those films. So, it's one of those skip here, you don't need to see this, no need to see. And then we'll, Sword Online Ordnance Scale, what are your thoughts going into that?
Low.
You're very low, because season 2 did not do much for us to get
I'm just not a fan of Sword Online. It's the series with the most wasted potential.
I'm much more a fan of Sword Online than you, aren't I? Yeah, I've still got the, I get Loot Anime, so I've got Kirito socks. And everyone was saying, oh, why didn't you get Aston the socks? I'd say, oh, yeah, I wanted Aston the socks. They gave me fucking Kirito. that's how I... And I also got... But I did get an Aston figurine as well. And I've got... still haven't got a Sword Art Online shirt yet.
No.
Or the Kirito coat. That's the one thing. But what do you think about Kirito? He's got the coolest coat in the world.
That is true.
So that's our thoughts. So that's what we're going to be like going into those films. I'm going in a lot more optimistic, but at the same time, it's because I'm more of a Sword Online fan. I'm wondering if that... remember I did that... I wanted to convince people at that... group that Axia manages, I wanted to convince people to go for loot crates as a Christmas gift for geeks.
Yeah.
And I did an unboxing of the loot anime. I got that Sword Online Progressive manga in that crate. Do you reckon is it based on that one? Because I've been holding off reading that for that reason.
Yeah, I've got no idea.
Because they look like they're wearing the same outfits they get in the movie. So I'm actually not going to read that manga until I've done with the movie, I'm actually going Friday to see, Friday from this recording. So by the time this is up, I might have actually already seen it. But you got your tickets for either of those films?
Not yet.
Get those tickets, because we're going to be discussing it. And that's us for the first episode of Anime Amigos. Next month, I don't know if anyone's going to be joining us next month. I know next month we've definitely got my friend Ren joining us. So we'll be going through his 5 favourite anime. And he's coming with me to go see Ghost in the Shell, so it'll be both of our experiences that we'll be relaying. Although we're both going to see Sword Online separately because I can't make it to the cinema he wants to go to. Because again, the trains around this area are just useless. They've got to get a cinema in Chester at some point. You live in the arsehole of nowhere and you go to cinema.
Yeah, because I finally just got like a half an hour drive up to Didsbury. Near me.
And it's at least an hour's drive, if not a 40-minute train ride. Well, that's our first episode of Amigos. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for watching.
We'll see you next month for Ghost in the Shell and Sword Art Online. Which one do you reckon we should do first? Because I want people to actually watch the whole thing.
I think probably Sword Art Online has more casual followers.
Yeah, but at the same time, Sword Art Online is not the thing that the people on the... I think we should do Sword Art Online first, because otherwise... Right, the time Ghost in the Shell and all the real big anime fans are like, we're done. They've talked about Ghost in the Shell, we don't give a shit about Sword Art Online. And in a second I'll say that anything positive about it, they'll say, you absolute casual watcher, you don't know nothing about anime.
Yeah.
Like, calm down, it's not as bad as you thought it was.
And remember, all opinions are subjective. You're more than welcome to like what you want to like.
Yeah.
We're just here to give you our thoughts on them.
Yeah. Incidentally, we want to know what your thoughts were. What were your thoughts on each of our choices of the category? And before you say anything, yes, we did rip off Age Brandon's method for how he rounds up the year with the categories, but I couldn't think of anything else to do. It works the perfect thing. Sorry, Brandon, we love you.